but there were female pop artists who attacked the chauvinism of popular culture and were then sidelined for years. One of them has lived here at the Chelsea Hotel since the 60s, and it's only recently that Nicola L has been embraced as a pop artist.
Hello. Nicola, hello.
Alastair.
Yes, good. Well, good to meet you. If so, right, the zip's down here.
Yes. Oh, you know it, really. That's great.
What's happening here?
It's a kind of construction destruction.
It's like a war zone.
Is this sculpture or furniture? Is it pop or surrealism? In a playful fashion, Nicola L objectifies women, literally. The women on offer here are very different from the pin-ups of classic pop. But they still fizz with all its ironic wit.
This is the iron table, and it is a woman.
A woman? And like, this is... quite a lot of your furniture is a woman. Is this a woman's giant green foot? Can I sit on it?
Yes, so please, I'd love to see you on it.
So this is, right. I mean, this is, it's a work of art as well as a piece of furniture.
Yes.
Well, it is very comfortable.
Yes?
I've got to ask you about this. Do you actually use this for real?
Oh, yes. You know, this is for my check.
Do you keep things in the drawers?
Yes. This is my credit card. This is whatever. You know, it is on wheels. You can dance with it if you want.
Yeah? That's amazing.
Nicola L made this furniture when she arrived in New York in 1967. It was a radical departure from her early work in Paris. There, she had studied as a painter and struggled for visibility in the macho art scene.
My name was Nicola without S at the School of Beaux-Arts in Paris. So I put an S at my name, Nicola, so it seemed a guy, you know?
And it works.
So the guy came and look, he said, "You are a girl." You know, completely, you know, so I could see he was really disappointed.
Like most art students at the start of the 60s, Nicola first made abstract paintings.
I had the feeling that nobody was really looking at my work. And one day, I made five holes.
I see, for the head and the limbs.
And I went inside.
Right. Great.
Yeah.
So you actually put your whole legs and feet...
Right. I tried to do it, huh? We have to be. So suddenly I was asking them to be inside the painting.
Yeah, right.
You know? And voila.
Nicola's eccentric paintings became a series of work called The Penetrables. The most striking example is Same Skin for Everyone, a red coat for 11 people, which Nicola has carried around the world in a suitcase. In every new city, she invites passers-by to join her in putting on the coat. Helping each other inside, the strangers become joined by a common skin and walk together. It's often seen as a plea for tolerance and a protest against racism.
They're saying that you're a pop artist.
Yeah.
Whereas in most of the histories of pop,
you're
not explicitly there.
You have to have a long life if you are a woman, you know. It's easier to be a man for my generation, you know.
Nicola wasn't alone. Pop art included several important female artists who, like her, were subsequently ignored. Artists like Rosalind Drexler, Pauline Boaty, Marisol, and Evelyn Axel. Their work had a more explicit, passionately political quality than the ironic, cool carapace of classic pop. And the artists were in good company. In the 60s and 70s, new strands of pop art emerged, harnessing pop's knack for stylishly recycling the strategies of advertising. Younger artists began to use pop's powers of persuasion to sell a very different kind of product, radical change.